Most respected, dear family members, my pranams to you. Many people, many parents used to ask me the question, what to teach our children and how to teach our children. They used to say they are very much attracted towards the values. They are very much fond of Indian heritage. But the parents themselves are ignorant about these values and Indian heritage. So they are in a doubtful condition how to teach and what to teach their children. From my experience, even day before yesterday, I was fortunate enough to take class for about 200 students in Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, Thrissur, and also Sharada Mission School in Thrissur. I found the students are so much interested, deeply interested in learning the values and heritage of India. The takers are very much ready to take the messages. But those who are expected to give these values, they do not know what is meant by value. They do not know what is meant by the heritage of India. Many a time it is observed that when we tell, give messages from Mahabharatam or Ramayanam, the teachers and the parents give details about the people of Mahabharata, actors of Mahabharata, role players of Mahabharata, not the message. For example, many teachers teach about Mahabharata, who is the husband of Gandhari, who is the wife of Dhritarashtra, how many children Dhritarashtra had, and who is Vidura, who is the husband of Panjali. This is not heritage. These are all information connected with the role players in Mahabharata. But what is to be taught from Mahabharata? What happened when Dhritarashtra was blind and Gandhari tied her eyes? When father is blind and mother tied her eyes, what happened to their children? When Dhritarashtra played the dice, what happened to Pandavas? When Shakuni did all the crooked thing and Duryodhana followed that, what happened to Kauravas? And why Vidura gave messages to Dhritarashtra and what was the messages? And why only Bhishma had to lie on the arrow of bed? Why Dharmaputra had to tell a lie to kill Dronacharya? Why Shikhandi was kept in front for shooting arrow towards Bhishma? This why, what, when, where, how? These are important from Mahabharata, not who. Who is not that important, even if it comes. Coming back to our subject, what is to be taught to the children, what are to be taught to the students? Such a question is asked. To my dear family members who are watching this YouTube, I would like to say 70% you teach them syllabus-based modern knowledge. Syllabus-based modern knowledge and slightly above that. So remember, 70% of the modern knowledge needed for writing the examination and coming out in flying colors in their examinations to be given compulsory, whether it is from the school or from the family or by tuition or by other support. 10% you give general knowledge from wheresoever they are available. Maybe Discovery Channel, Natural Geography Channel, History Channel, Animal Planet Channel, or through CDs or DVDs or through any other sources, magazines, weeklies, monthlies, 10% general knowledge is compulsory. 10% you give value-based knowledge for elevating the mind from bad to good. Value-based knowledge for elevating the health of the body through traditional method. Value-based knowledge for fantastic family relation building. The value-based knowledge for strengthening social bondage. Value-based knowledge for improving the national integration pathways. So 70% knowledge you are giving, purely syllabus based modern knowledge. 10% you are giving general knowledge. 10% you are expected to give value based knowledge connecting the mind, body, family, society and nation. Give as much as possible for elevating the mind from darkness to light, from bad to good, from silly things to permanent good things. Fill the mind with good things. And teach your children vegetarian food, yoga, and customs and rituals for strengthening the body. Similarly, strengthening the family relation. Whatever you have to do, do that. Strengthening the social bondage and strengthening the national integration. Those 5 points are included in the value-based knowledge. So modern knowledge, general knowledge, value-based knowledge, last 10% Indian heritage knowledge. Heritage knowledge in mathematics, heritage knowledge in health science, heritage knowledge in spirituality, heritage knowledge in Puranas, Itihasas, Vedas, Upanishads, heritage knowledge on metallurgy, heritage knowledge on astronomy, and so on. So once you have divided the whole knowledge imparting system as 7:1:1:1, your burden is reduced. When you are giving the modern knowledge, try to teach point by point to them. You know how Vedas are taught? So interestingly, Vedas are taught. When Vedic Rik, Vedic Haim, Vedic Stansa, each word, if it is A, B, C, D, E, then Vedas are taught to the students A, B, B, A, B, C, C, B, A, B, C, C, B, B, C, D, D, C, B, B, C, D, C, D, D, C, C, D, E, E, D, C, like that. Not only marching forward, but coming back is also needed. Say for example, Te ha nakam mahimana sajanda yatra purve satya sandhi devaha. This is a Vedic line. How it is taught, you know? Te ha ha te te ha nakam nakam ha te te ha nakam nakam ha ha nakam mahimana mahimana nakam ha ha nakam mahimana mahimana nakam nakam mahimana sajanda sajanda nakam mahimana mahimana नागम सजंद सजंद नागम नागम सजंद यत्र यत्र सजंद महीमान महीमान सजंद यत्र। सो यू आर गोइंग फॉरवर्ड एंड बैकवर्ड। दिस इन वे दस नोन एज घनवाड़म। आई एम नॉट टेलिंग यू दैट यू शुड टीच घनवाड़म इन यूर केमिस्ट्री और फिजिक्स और मैथमेटिक्स। व्हाट आई एम टेलिंग, जस्ट लाइक 99.9% ऑफ द स्पीकर्स और टीचर्स और ओरेटर्स, दे मूव फ्रॉम ए टू इज़ेड। दैट इज नॉट व्हाट इज नीडेड फॉर टीचिंग। टीचिंग मूव फॉरवर्ड एंड कम बैक, दैट इज व्हाट इज नीडेड। व्हाट एवर यू हैव टोल्ड, देन यू हैव टू कम बैक। सो व्हेन यू आर टीचिंग 70% मॉडर्न नॉलेज, 10% जनरल नॉलेज, 10% वैल्यू बेस्ड नॉलेज एंड 10% इंडियन हेरिटेज नॉलेज, 7:1:1:1, मॉडर्न नॉलेज इज टू बी टॉट इन सच ए वे दैट यू कन्वर्ट एवरी सेंटेंस इन द टेक्स्ट बुक इन टू ए क्वेश्चन। इंडिया इज अवर मदरलैंड। India became free, independent in 1947, August 15th. And Mahatma Gandhi was the leader of freedom fight. Ask the question about which country we are talking, which year we said it now, which month, and which date. What is the importance of that date? About whom we are talking, who was the leader of the freedom fight. So you asked all the questions. Like that, hydrogen plus chlorine gives hydrogen chloride. If dissolved, it will become hydrochloric acid. So what are the two gases we are talking? And what is the speciality of hydrogen? What is the speciality of chlorine? If these two are combined, what will happen? And if that gas is dissolved in water, what we will get? So clear. So you teach the modern knowledge in such a way that they not only learn but also understand. They not only learn but also understand. You support your children, motivate them, appreciate them, bless them, console them. And we have got a school, Bharatiya Vidyavika. More than 1020 students are studying there. Heavy rush is there. We used to teach like this only, 70% modern knowledge. While teaching the modern knowledge, every week we used to take the number of SLS. What is SLS? Slow learning students. SLS, slow learning students. That slow learning student may not be slow in every subject. Last time when I went to Bharatiya Vidyavihar, Mazhuvancheri, Eranellur, near Kecheri, Trichur, our school, the 10th standard I used to take class. I asked them, how many of you are backward in biology? One student raised his hand. How many students are back in physics? Three students. How many feel scared about mathematics? Five students. How many in chemistry? 4 or 5 students. And after 2 weeks, and when I took that list, I told them, now dear student, you know you are weak in biology. Focus for biology for coming 2 weeks, slightly higher than the time allotted for learning other subjects. So remember, that fellow spent 2 weeks with the taking strain but determination, for which motivation was given, appreciation was given. And after 2 weeks, that student said, now I like chemistry very much, and now I like biology very much. Like that, SLS, slow learning students, can be converted into fast learning students. Teach them thoroughly, not the exercises given after that particular lesson or in the end of the lesson. Once one lesson is over, that student should understand what are the knowledgeable material given in that. Try to write in a newspaper, in a paper or scribble, so that learning by reading, learning by hearting, learning by listening, learning by writing will be taking place. Modern knowledge. Next one is general knowledge. Make it a point that you collect general knowledge and give the general knowledge to your children or students, minimum 4 or 5 points per day, casually. General knowledge does not mean how many years Shah Jahan lived. General knowledge means what are the messages given by Abraham Lincoln to the teachers when he was taking his son to the school. What are the messages given by Socrates? And what happened to Osama bin Laden, who was terrorizing the world? What happened to Saddam Hussein, who was butchering thousands and thousands of youngsters in the name of plotting against him? And how a black man entered into a White House, Obama? And what is the background of Dr. Manmohan Singh? And remember that these are all general knowledge. Merely studying the name of an individual is not general knowledge. That general knowledge, GK, should lead our boy or girl to take the highest degree, to live in this world with the world-based knowledge. So 70% subject-based, syllabus-based knowledge, 10% general knowledge. General knowledge should include life of Mahatma Gandhi. General knowledge should include Swami Vivekananda's message, Ramana Maharshi's message. General knowledge should include the knowledge in Bhagavad Gita, knowledge, the messages given in Bible, messages given in Quran, messages given in Communist Manifesto, messages given by Mao Zedong, messages about Karl Marx, Engels. Not the way our so-called cheap communists are living or making this knowledge for livelihood through bucket collection. Not that way. But go deep into the subject. Do addition, deletion, modification and correction. And take good from the general knowledge. That is what is meant by general knowledge. In the subject-based knowledge, you do not have to do addition, deletion, modification and correction. In general knowledge, you have to do addition, deletion, modification and correction. Because whatever Mahatma Gandhi said need not be applicable fully now. Whatever Mao Zedong said for Chinese people cannot be applied in India in toto. Whatever Karl Marx told 185 years before his birth, 185 years it took after his birth. And Karl Marx's message may not be relevant now fully, but some may be relevant. So learn about it. General knowledge. That should be always applicable for the student whenever he is discussing with others. And whenever people discuss many subject, our children, our son or daughter should not get out of that discussion boundary. He should also be in a position to contribute something while others discussing a particular subject. So modern knowledge, then comes general knowledge, then 10% value-based knowledge, about which I have already told you. Elevating the mind, this I have explained many times through the YouTube uploading messages. All the stories, the messages and experiences of people, they are needed for elevating the mind. The tonic for elevating the mind, for energizing the mind, activating the mind, confidence building in the mind, courage building in the mind, takes place through the experiences of other people, narrating the experiences of other people, and also giving excellent messages. Several examples: Uttishtada, Jagrada, Prapyavara, Nibodada, Churasya Dhara, Nishita Duratyaya, Durgam Padastat Kavayo Vadandi, Kadopanishad. Swami Vivekananda always used to quote these messages. Uttishtada, gloriously stand up. Jagrada, be aware that you are not permanent in this world. Prapyavara Nibodada, acquire knowledge from the scholars and enlighten yourself. Uttishtada Jagrada Prapyavara Nibodada, fill that in the mind. Satyam Vada Dharmam Chara Swatyayanma Pramada Satyanna Pramadidavyam Dharmanna Pramadidavyam Bhutyayina Pramadidavyam. Even though these are all heritage knowledge, these are all value-based knowledge also. Values given by Mahatma Gandhi should be learned and taught. Values given by Swami Vivekananda should be learned and taught. So you can see general knowledge and value-based knowledge and heritage knowledge go hand in hand. You cannot separate them by constructing walls or fences. They are complementary, coexisting, cooperating, and not confusing, not contradicting. That is important. So value-based knowledge as a continuation, you can give heritage knowledge also. Give heritage knowledge. Value-based knowledge, as I told you, filling the mind with confidence, filling the mind with fearlessness, filling the mind with optimism, and filling the mind with pride about our nation and our society. Filling the mind with Ichha Shakti, Jnana Shakti and Kriya Shakti. This is what is meant by value-based knowledge. Values are for practicing, not merely for writing the examination. So value-based knowledge for elevating the mind, for strengthening your body. Teach them yoga, teach them pranayama. Make compulsory vegetarian food and follow customs and rituals. Get up early morning, sit on the bed, pray, touch the floor, take bath before eating food, pray, compulsory. A systematic life and a customatic life. That will make the body strong. Build the family relation. Wife, husband, mother, father, children in the family. Teach everything connected with family relation to your children. Do Matra Dharma, then only advise your children. Do Pitra Dharma, then only advise your children. Let your children touch mother's feet before going to the school and touch the feet of the parents before going for examination. Teach them good habit. We in our school, we are teaching it. We could see the change in them. We could literally see. And it is marvelous. It can be video photographed and demonstrated. How the students behave, keep a smiling face. How they say Vande Mataram. How they say Namaste. How they say good morning. And you can see gem of the students. You can convert a man into Osama. You can convert a man into Obama. How you bring them up? Osama was born for a mother. Obama was also born for a mother. But one mother nurtured to such a level that boy becomes American president. Another mother nurtured knowingly or unknowingly in such a way that he became fanatic and a terrorist. So how you nurture your children in your family, that is great. And build social bondage, national integration. Do everything for our country. There comes Indian heritage knowledge. Teach them Puranas. Teach them Mahabharata. Whether you are a Christian or a Muslim, these are all out of question. You are Indian. Your blood is Indian blood. And you may be olden days, your forefathers are forefathers were Hindus. Now you might have accepted a foreign religion. Does not mean you are foreigner. You are not here in India from Mecca or Jerusalem. You are not an American. You are not a Russian from Moscow. You are not a Taliban. You are an Indian. An Indian first, Indian second, Indian third. So Indian heritage is your heritage. All the good and bad present here belong to you also. You cannot say, I inherit everything from Mecca. I inherit everything from Moscow. I inherit everything from Jerusalem. There may be one book which you are following, but thousands and thousands of books are here in India as your heritage. If you are going to Saudi Arabia and doing some crime, people will be pushing you to India back. They will not look whether you are a Muslim or a Hindu. If you do something, some crime in Jerusalem, Israel, they will not ask you whether you are a Christian or a Jew. If your passport shows you are Indian, you will be thrown back to Bombay or any other cities of India. Why? You are Indian first. You are Indian second. You are Indian third. Then only you are a Hindu or Muslim or Christian. Hindu, Muslim, Christian is mind. Body is Indian. So, learn Indian heritage. I have seen Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. About 30% of the students are Christians, about 10% Muslims. They have to read Ramayana, they have to chant Veda Mantra, they have to chant Upanishad Mantra, they have to participate in Vijayadashmi celebration, of course Christmas also. What does it mean? They are part and parcel. Nobody compelled these parents, Christian parents and Muslim parents, to take admission for their children in Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. But I asked the principal. Principal said, very many number of Christians and Muslims are coming for getting admission in Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. Why? They know that their heritage is this. They may be praying in church or mosque. Does not mean that Indian heritage does not belong to them. So learn Indian heritage. Not only Indian heritage about Ramayana, Mahabharata, etc., but also Indian heritage in mathematics, heritage in astronomy, as I told you, our civil engineering marvel, our metallurgical marvels, and our granite technology, our technology in Intra Sarvaswam, and these are all the heritage of every Indian. Learn that also. So by concluding, I would like to say, 70% you teach connected with your syllabus of the children, of your son or daughter. 10% you focus on general knowledge world over, whatever is happening. 10% you teach the value-based knowledge connected with the mind, body, family, society and nation. And 10% you teach Indian heritage in mathematics, chemistry, health science, or any subject connected with India, directly Indian contribution to the world. Thus, now you know what are the subjects to be taught. Let your children become good and great. Just come once in a while to Bharatiya Vidya Vihar in Maluvanjeri, which is a CBSE school, where we teach them both values, general knowledge, and Indian heritage plus modern knowledge. They are students, children with confidence, with a smiling face. That is what we need. I'm sure, wherever you are teaching your children, teach them these 4 points, either from the school or partly from the school, partly from your home. That is Matra Dharma and Pitra Dharma too. With these words, I bow my head with pranams. Thank you very much.